Circuit breaker is a device used for interruption of normal as well as short circuit current. You can operate circuit breaker when the supply is on and as well as when the supply is off. And hence it is called as an on-load device. Whereas disconnectors or isolators has no ability to break normal or fault current. We can only operate disconnectors in current zero condition. That is, when the supply is off, and hence disconnector is called as offload device. Now when it is known that disconnectors cannot break any current, then why do we use them? To know the answers and to get some more differences between circuit breaker and disconnectors, you need to watch the video. We cannot operate disconnector when supply is on. Why we cannot? Because disconnector has no mechanism to interrupt the fault or normal current. It also does not have any insulation medium like SF6 gas or oil. If you would like to know more about SF6 gas, you can watch my video on that. You will get link for that video in the description of this video. Circuit breaker can work automatically. Whenever the circuit breaker gets command from relay, it operates. However, to operate disconnector, you have to either go to the disconnector and press the push button, or you have to operate it from the control room. It does not operate automatically. As the name suggests, disconnectors or isolator is used to disconnect or isolate part of a system which needs to undergo maintenance work. To understand this, we will have a look on a single line diagram. So as you can see, this is a SLD of a 400 kV by 245 kV substation. This symbol indicates the horizontal center break type disconnector with single earth switch, and this symbol indicates the circuit breaker. So let's say I want to carry out the maintenance of this circuit breaker. In such cases, it is a safe practice to completely disconnect this breaker from the supply. And hence, to do so, I'll open both of these disconnectors, which will completely isolate this breaker from the supply. Now, the maintenance work can be carried out without any worry. So similarly, if I want to carry out the maintenance of this section, I'll simply open these two disconnectors. This symbol indicates a double break type disconnector with two earth switches. Whereas the breaker is used to protect the system from fault current, it is not used to carry out any kind of maintenance activity. Another important application of disconnector is to remove the trapped charges from the system. Consider the same section. To carry out the maintenance, we have opened both of these disconnectors, but there is a possibility that there are some trapped charges still remaining in this section. And if the person who is carrying out the maintenance on this section accidentally touches any of the conductor, there is a possibility that those trap charges will flow through his body to ground. And in such case, the life of that person is in danger. And hence, to avoid such situation, disconnectors are provided with earth switches. After you open the disconnector, just close the earth switch and all the trap charges will flow through that earth switch to ground. And of course, this facility is not provided in circuit breaker. Next important application which most of the people forget to tell is to reroute the power flow. For this application, disconnectors works exactly same as the railway tracks, which helps the railway to change its route or lane. In most of the substation, two buses are provided. One is main bus and another is auxiliary bus. So in case if one of the bus fails, we can take the supply from another and continue to deliver the power. And to reroute this power from one bus to another, disconnectors are used. Here you can see we are taking power from main bus 1, but because of some reason we have to shut down this bus. In such cases, we can open this disconnector and then close this disconnector and turn on the main bus 2. And there you go, you just rerouted the power. Of course, circuit breaker cannot serve this purpose. The main function of breaker is to protect the system from fault current. And because of all these reasons, disconnector or isolator are used in substation. While operating disconnector, we must open the disconnector only when the associated circuit breaker is opened. And while closing, we must close the disconnector first and then the circuit breaker. One more difference in the circuit breaker and disconnector is that circuit breaker's closing and opening operation causes over voltages in the system. But disconnector operation does not cause any over voltages in the system as it is an offload device. If you want to download this point wise comparison, you can do that too. Click on the link given in the description of this video. Most of the details about the equipment are mentioned on the nameplate of that equipment, and it is important that we understand all the parameters mentioned on the nameplate. And for that, you can watch my nameplate detail series, which will help you to understand the details. You'll get link for that in the description of this video as well. If you like the video, you know what to do. That's all for this video, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching.